What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Trafish Aquatics. Today we're going to be doing a species spotlight of the pea puffer. And as you can see, these little guys right here, well, you guys probably can't see them. This little guy right here is known as the pea puffer, and in many ways, he is considered one of the perfect oddball fish for new aquarium keepers, as well as nano aquarium keepers. The pea puffer, also called a dwarf puffer, is a freshwater puffer species that is very small. They only get about an inch long when full grown, and therefore can be kept in smaller aquariums, unlike many other puffers that get much larger and require more space, like the dragon puffer, the fajaca puffer, and the mabu puffer. They're all freshwater, but they all get 8 inches, 18 inches, and 3 feet long. So the pea puffer is perfect for those of you who have smaller aquariums if you really want to get in the field of keeping a puffer fish. They're super cool, very active, they're very inquisitive with their environment, and they are really, really cool fish. I'm going to tell you a little story about how I got mine. I was on Craigslist looking because I like to go out and find people who are trying to rehome fish, and if I have the capability, I will take them and give them a new good home, as opposed to giving them back to a fish store and potentially ending up in the hands of a store that doesn't want to take care of them properly, or an uneducated fish keeper, especially when you're dealing with puffers. Now, puffers, you have to be careful because they do have beaks, and the beaks will grow, and if you don't keep those beaks filed down or worn down or trimmed, they can overgrow. The puffer won't be able to eat food properly, and it will essentially starve itself to death because the teeth, little beaks that come together like this, will overgrow each other, and when they open their mouth doesn't actually open all the way. So these guys, that's not as big of an issue. It's more predominant with Amazon puffers, dragon puffers, fajacas, the larger ones. It's more of a predominant issue. These guys, not so much, but it still could become an issue. So I went on Craigslist, I was looking for fish, and I found a gentleman named Dan, and he had 8 pea puffers that he was trying to rehome, but he wanted to make sure that the person that was going to be receiving these fish knew what they were doing. And after talking with Dan for a little bit, he determined that I was a reasonable fish keeper, I knew what I was doing, and I would be able to provide them a good home. I met up with him, he gave me these fish, I brought them home, and this is their living environment. So far I've had them for about a month now, maybe a little longer, and everybody's doing very well. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get right into the species profile and let you guys know what the base requirements are to be able to keep these guys happy and healthy in your home aquarium. Alright, so the scientific name for the pea puffer is the Serenotetradon travancorsius. That's the Latin name for these guys. I probably butchered it, but that's my best shot. But that's the scientific name for these guys. Common names that you can find these guys as, depending on the fish store you go to, they're going to call them different things. But if you see them labeled as pea puffer, dwarf puffer, pygmy puffer, bumblebee puffer, the BB puffer, they're all the same fish. Those are general names that are used to encompass these little guys. The overall care level for these fish is very easy. As long as you keep clean water and feed these guys the appropriate foods, they're going to do very well for you. Maximum size of these fish is about an inch, with a pH of 6.5 to 7.5, so a relatively good range. And you can go outside that range a little bit on each side and everybody will be perfectly happy. Temperature 76 to 82, so they can be a little bit cooler than tropical, but tropical temperatures are usually about ideal. This tank is kept at 78 degrees. The water hardness, if you're looking at the overall hardness for your aquarium water, 5 to 20 degrees, so a very moderate hardness to a fairly hard amount of water is going to do well. Lifespan for your pea puffers is approximately 5 years. Some live longer, some don't live as long, but on average, 5 years is pretty good. I know that these guys are at least 2 years old because Dan had them for that long before he had to rehome them. So I know these guys are 2 years old. These are full-grown adults, and they are only about an inch long. The original location of these fish, their origin, if you would, is the inland waters of India. Right, so very cool to see these guys coming from across the world to the United States to be kept in our home aquariums. The temperament of these fish, they are fin nippers and they're semi-aggressive, so you have to be very careful. Species only tank is best for these guys. But if they're going to do good with any other fish, they usually do well with autosynclus catfish, the little algae eater. They're going to help keep the tank pretty clean, and overall, they don't bother them too much. If you have other fish in your tank, like anything with long fins, platies, mollies, guppies, things like that, common aquarium fish, these guys most likely are going to pick on them, chew their fins up, and that could eventually lead to them dying. So you don't want that to happen. And the reverse can happen as well. Those fish can pick on the puffers because the puffers aren't super fast fish. So you want to stay away. Species-only tank is usually the best idea. Tank size for these guys, 10-gallon minimum for your first one, and then 5 gallons for each additional. I have 8 of them. This is a 29-gallon aquarium. It's plenty of room for them, lots of open space, but it is planted. I have a lot of Java fern in here, as well as driftwood and rock. So lots of hiding places, lots of territory for them to cover. No aggression at all. Everybody's doing very well. For food for these guys, personally, I feed frozen bloodworms. Now, you can get these at your local fish store. PetSmart, Petco, and all the chain stores usually have a freezer over in their fish area that sells these foods as well. I feed the Omega 1 frozen bloodworms. All right, they come in a little pack like this, little punch pack. You just punch them out. I usually chop these cubes up into 4, so you get 4 days worth of feeding out of 1 cube. And this pack has a ton of cubes in it, so that's going to last you a really long time. And I think this pack cost me $7, but the price of it's going to vary depending on where you live. So there's that. So while I have this out, I'm going to drop a little bit of a cube, one of these little pieces I've cut in here, to see if we can get these guys motoring around a little bit. Now, in addition to bloodworms, I also feed these guys live snails. Now, I don't have a culture of snails going in a different tank. This tank already had a culture in it before they got it. This tank is loaded with Malaysian trumpet snails. I don't know if you guys can see on camera. I'll show some pictures here, but there are snail shells littering the bottom because these guys are destroying them. So they'll go around, they'll pick it up. Now, these guys don't have a strong enough beak to crunch down on the larger snails, but they do have a strong enough suction that they can actually suck the snail out of the shell and eat it that way. So these guys do very well with snails and bloodworms. You want to make sure you have a varied diet so that they're not just eating one thing to where they would get a deficiency. Now, other things that you can feed them, you can do live brine shrimp, you can do baby brine shrimp, you can do frozen brine shrimp. You can do Daphnia, Mysis shrimp, and as I said, any kind of snail will do well for these guys. So make sure you keep a varied diet, and these guys are going to do wonderful. As far as tank region, where these guys are going to be in the tank, as you can probably see, middle to top is most of the time where they're going to be, but primarily middle. You're not going to see them too much on the bottom unless you're feeding or they're eating snails. Most of the time they're in the middle. As far as gendering these fish, it's kind of hard to do until they reach adulthood. So basically, the females are going to be bigger bodied, the males are going to be much more slender, and the females are going to get a stripe along their belly. I'll see if I can get a picture and post it here so you guys can see the stripe. If I can't, maybe I'll find one on Google and post it in the link down below, but I'm going to try and get a picture up here for you guys. The females will get a stripe down their belly, the males don't get that, so when they've reached adulthood, that's a very easy way to tell. As far as breeding for these guys, if you plan to breed them, it is very difficult to breed. You have to keep a 3-to-1 ratio of female to male, 3 females, 1 male, and at that point you leave them alone, condition them with feeding, keep the water nice and clean, and then you might see them starting to do a mating dance. They do a little mating dance, and then they'll spawn. But it's very difficult. There have not been a ton of documented cases on breeding these guys, but these are the methods that the experts use when they breed these fish. So I'm just passing along that information. I don't have any plan on breeding these guys, but if an accidental breeding happens, I'll try and document it for you guys. So for the most part, that is all of the general information for these fish, for basic fish keeping of the pea puffer. So what I'm going to do now is I put some food in here. I'm going to go get a little bit more food. I'm going to put it in there. We'll shoot some B-roll so you guys can watch the antics of the pea puffer. Thank you guys for watching Trapfish Aquatics. As always, links in the description down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video.
So here we'll just take a little bit of bloodworm and we'll drop it in the tank up top. I'll show you guys it drop in there.